Michael Dwyer is my name. I'll not deny the same. In the mountains of West Wicklow I was born. I was in a fight of late with the man of 98 when we took an escorty by storm. When the rising was put down, we very quickly found that in our own homes we could no longer dwell. Ah, but many's a lonely cave some form of comfort gave, and the people of these mountains know us well. Well, the snow was falling fast and the night was far advanced when the three safe houses came in view. The weather was severe, but a guard was posted near, though the dangers on a night like this seemed few. But some sneaking little spy to his master he did fly, and may I live to even up the score. For it's when we awoke, to be sure it was no joke, to find 100 Highland soldiers at the door. Come out, you rebel band, cried the captain in command. You do not have a prayer, not a hope. Surrender to me now, and your lives, I vow, will be spared the bullet and the rope. Says Dwyer to his men, boys, here we are again, though I'm afraid this time it cannot be denied. It would take more than God's grace to defend this place from a regiment of soldiers outside. The house was set on fire with McAllister and Dwyer, expecting to perish in the flames. With the powder and the smoke they were nearly overcome, crying a curse upon your bloody Highland games. From behind the stable wall a well-aimed musket ball caused McAllister pain he could not hide. As his gun was blown away, he looked down with dismay at his arm hanging useless by his side. He says, Dwyer, I'm done, hand me up your gun, let's see what a spring you can make. As he opened the door, he gave one loud roar, I die for my country's sake. The volley rang out and Dwyer sprang forth, poor Sam received the fire. Oh, generous and brave, McAllister gave up his life for Michael Dwyer. Well, before they could reload, he was halfway down the road with a kilted Scotsman snapping at his heels. The troopers held their fire till they saw what might transpire, and they watched as Dwyer tripped him in the field. Running like a mountain goat, no trousers, no coat, his bare feet were bleeding to be sure. As he crossed the black banks, he offered hearty thanks and got safely to a cave in Glenmalure. We lost 3 men that day, our captain got away, and the others surrendered on the spot. 3 of them, alas, were hanged in Balting Glass, the others went before the firing squad. Dwyer fought the law 5 years, maybe more, till at last to Dublin he did go. And from there he set sail, bound for New South Wales, far from the county Wicklow.